Reaper loudness tools take 5, 4. How many is this? Welcome back to Reaper for Podcasting. I'm Daniel Abendroth. And in this video, we're going to be talking about all the new loudness tools that have come out in the recent Reaper updates. Now, in my last video, I talked about some updates with the sound panelings and different things. So if you want some more updates about me and this channel and a few different things, feel free to stick around. If you don't care about any of that and you want to get straight into the content, check the progress bar down below or the description, because I'll have chapters in the progress bar and timestamps in the description, so you can jump straight to the content or any specific feature that you want to see. For those that do want updates, here we go. All right, so this is, I think, the fourth time I've attempted to record this video. It started out as a 6.30 update, and right now I think we're sitting at 6.33. So a little late on that one. So this one, I'm going to focus specifically on the loudness tools and not the couple other things that I found interesting in this update. The reason for so many attempts is, so you know, I'm using the new background. I've also got a new camera. I'm using the Panasonic Lumix G7, which is a fantastic camera, but it actually, you had to know what you're doing just a little bit, and I didn't. So if you saw my last video, the RX Connect, the lighting was pretty bad, and I looked ridiculous. Not a big fan of that. Not my proudest moment. So I tried to do a few things. I actually got new lighting panels, went to record, wasn't paying attention, and I didn't even focus. I was completely out of focus the entire video. So speaking of, let me just... Okay, good. And then the next time I recorded, the lighting was really bad and I was like super orange. I don't know what happened before. Just before here, I actually recorded the entire video and it actually wasn't recording anything at all. So... here we go. Temp number 4 or 5. So I don't know how many. So fingers crossed this works. Everything's recording. The lighting is okay. Okay, so updates to sound panels. Ask for your thoughts, your opinions on what I can do, because I'm renting and I can't damage the walls and it can't have anything permanent. Got a lot of really good suggestions. Some more practical than others. One person suggested actually using command strips, and I was doing that before, but I also had a Velcro strip, and that's what gave way, because I wanted to be able to move the panels and actually access the command strips, though thinking actually probably could work if I point them outwards and just cover them with other panels, but even then, I don't know how that'd work. Anyway, so not a big fan of that one, plus hanging all those up again is going to be kind of annoying. But one suggestion that really intrigued me came from Brian Entminger, fellow Yeti from the Podcast Editor's Mastermind. He sent me a video and I'll put that video in the description. So if you're interested in these, you can see the guy, I'm getting the idea from. It is, so you take metal studs and you make the frame and then you fill that with sound dampening insulation. And then I'm probably going to get MDF board and, put that on the front of it, wrapped in fabric, and then hang that on the wall. And he used drywall hooks, which is a great idea. Like I said, I can't do a whole lot of damage, and a small hole is going to be super easy to repair whenever I move out. And they're pretty light, so it can just hang on the wall, not a problem. And he actually also had cloud panels, I think they're called, so put them on the ceiling. So thinking about doing that. So I think that's the way I'm going to go through. Should be pretty inexpensive, easy to do. And I'll probably make a video out of that, my process of actually creating them. The other thing, so I was talking about lighting. Even now, I'm not super thrilled with my lighting. And I think a lot of it has to do with this big gold banner, because I'm not far from the wall. It's right here. If I had more separation, I think it would look a lot better. But as it is, I got all this light reflecting off this gold back into me. So it's really hard to get good color balance when it's just so much gold. So my solution to that, thinking about doing a green screen. So my wife streams on Twitch and she uses my setup, which is why we have the gold glitter in the first place. But she just bought a green screen piece of fabric that she's probably going to use at some point. So I'm thinking about doing that. Though I don't have the gold, I can just do like a motion graphic or something cool in the background for my videos and my live streams and all that. That kind of leads me into the reason I'm set up this way is because like that side of the room is not very attractive. So I wanted like this wall so I can have a good backdrop. And if I'm going to be doing a green screen, I might actually like flip myself around so I'm facing this wall, which I think is going to help a lot with the sound because I'll be speaking into the sound panels. And I can put some here, some over here, and also the cloud panels. I think that's what they're called. And just do a lot more to dampen the sound, whereas now I'm just kind of speaking into this open room that's not treated at all. We've got carpet, and I think I have a bookshelf here to kind of deflect some sound. And also, I have the air conditioning unit right behind me, which has been proving to be quite tricky. So we have the podcast editors mastermind, and we give other editors the chance to edit our show, one, so we don't have to, and two, so they can get the experience and use it in their portfolio and hopefully kind of showcase their skills. And one recurring theme is how tough it is to deal with my audio because of that AC unit. So right now it's off and I've already been at this for like an hour now and it's starting to get pretty warm because at the time of this recording, I'm in early August in Tennessee where it gets hot and humid and I'm starting to feel it. So hopefully I can get through this video before I start sweating profusely, which I'm sure you really care about. I probably shouldn't even mention that at all. So I think that's all I have for updates. So let's go ahead and get into the content. And welcome back, everybody who decided to skip my updates. You really missed out. I suggest going back and watching that. Don't do it. So let's go ahead and get into all these cool loudness features. They came out a couple weeks ago, and I have been using them so much. Every project I work on, I'm using a few of these tools. They're so useful for getting, good loudness. We're going to go over 7 actions that are now in Reaper with these latest updates, dry run rendering, and a new JSFX tool that we can use. So let's go ahead and jump into Reaper. So I've got an episode of the Podcast Editor's Mastermind. I keep talking about that. If you're interested, check out the description. It's for professional podcast editors. So if you edit for other people, we talk about the business side of podcast editing. The first thing we're going to talk about is dry run rendering. So if you bring up the render to file menu, you'll see a new button called dry run, no output. And what this does is it goes through the rendering process and it calculates the loudness. However, it doesn't actually render a file. So this way you can check your loudness and not have to deal with an audio file and when you're done with it. So open this, click dry run, and you can see it's going through, and you'll notice this is all different as well. So one thing that's not a huge deal, but is kind of useful, nice little quality of life update from Reaper, is this completed. So it'll tell you percentage-wise how much has been completed. I thought that was a nice little touch. But what we're focusing on is loudness. And down here, you can see we have all this loudness information. So here is the track name or file name. So we're doing the master mix. So it's going to be the file. Peak, which is your true peak. So this is minus 0.7. How many times the audio was clipped? So I haven't done any because I have a limiter. The RMS integrated. So if you care about the RMS metric, that's that. The loudness range. And that's the variance from the quietest points to the loudest. And then the LUFS integrated, which is the average loudness over whatever period. So this is going to be the entire file. So right now, in this 18% of audio, we're sitting at minus 15.6. And it auto-detects stereo versus mono. So right here, this is a stereo track. So it's showing what the loudness in stereo is. And we're aiming for that minus 16 range. If this was a mono track, this would be closer to minus 19 because that's the equivalent mono to stereo. Go ahead and cancel that. The next thing we're going to look at is the JSFX plugin. So that's it right here. All you got to do, add plugin, filter for loudness under all your plugins. And it's this right here, loudness meter peak slash RMS slash LUFS. Add that on and you can see all this. So you can click on it to clear it. And I'm going to go ahead and start playing some audio and you can see and kind of show you. I'm going to talk about everything here. So this first one is your true peaks. That's what up here, what your true peak is. How many times it's clipped and it's stereo. So we have the two each side. right here is the LUFS M, which stands for momentary. So that's what the loudness is at this exact point in the audio. And so this is going to fluctuate quite a bit. And I think this is the loudest. So this is going to be the momentary max. And this is the loudest at any point that it gets. Here we have LUFS S, which is short term, which is over a little bit longer average of time. So calculates the loudness there. And right here is the max loudness over that short period of time. LRA is your loudness range. So that, again, is from the quietest points to the loudest, what that difference is. And then finally, we have LUFS integrated, which is the average loudness of whatever we've listened to during this reporting. If you've watched my Edit With Me's, my live streams that I do, you'll know that I use WLM for everything. I no longer need to do that. Now, this does look a lot better. I hope they kind of clean this up, make it look a little bit nicer. But knowing Reaper, it's probably not. It's very kind of the information you need and not so much the aesthetics. So I don't see this changing a whole lot. Hope they do. But now you no longer need to have a third-party plugin in order to calculate loudness. Love this. So now let's go ahead and get into all these new actions. So bring up your action list and then filter for loudness. And you can see we have 7 new actions. So I'm going to go through one by one and explain what each one does. So the first one is calculate loudness of master mix via dry run render. That's the same thing we saw right here on this dry run. It goes through the entire master mix, tells you what the loudness information is. Next one, calculate loudness of master mix within time selection via dry run render. All these are with dry run render, so it's not going to create a file when it's done rendering. So master mix within time selection. So it's going to be the entire file within this selection. So if I highlight this right here, run this action, it'll calculate from this point to this point of all the tracks mixed down. And it'll give you all that same information. The next one, calculate loudness of selected items, including take and track effects and settings, via dry run render. So let's say you just wanted to know what this item loudness is. Just click on the item, run it, and you'll get all that information. So on with this, since I've already done the editing and now it's just like a bunch of smaller items, it's not as useful as, let's say, you have like bigger chunks or like if you want the like entire file from an interview or whatever. These smaller items aren't as useful, but if you need it, there it is. One cool thing is if you select multiple items and run this, it separates it based on each item. So you have run the loudness reporting for each item and have it all split up. Very cool. Next one, calculate loudness of selected tracks via dry run render. So if you just want to find out what the loudness is on one track or multiple tracks, you can. So select the tracks you want, run this action, and it'll go through the process and give you the loudness for each track. So the next one is calculate loudness of selected tracks within time selection. So that's basically this one right here, except it splits it up for each track. So right now, if you see, I have this time selection and these 3 tracks selected. When I run that, it's just going to go from this point to this point with each track that I selected separated down into individual statistics. Now these two are the same thing as these two, except it forces it into mono. So for example, if I run this one, select a track via dry run, you see that it comes out as stereo. Whereas if I run it through this, it forces it into mono. Like I said before, all these features can detect mono versus stereo and adjust accordingly. So if you do just want the mono loudness, you can force that. So quick interruption here. I realized as I was editing this video that I forgot to go over one of the new features in these updates, and that is the readout on the master mixer. So right down here, we are now getting some loudness information. So I'm going to go ahead and play some audio, and you can see on the left and right, we now have this LUFS readout or the loudness readout. And then down here, we have the integrated LUFS down here. So if you want to customize this to your preference, just right-click on it, and now we have this master VU settings. There's a couple that I want to go over. First off, this mixer meters. So I have mine set to peaks and loudness. You can set it to just peaks, just loudness, or both. The mixer top readout, I have mine set to peak. And what that means is right up here, you'll be seeing the peaks and on the bottom, the loudness. If you wanted to switch that, just change the top readout to loudness. And now we have loudness on top with the peaks on the bottom. We can change what the readout is measuring. So right now mine is set to momentary. You can change that to an RMS standard, or you can change it to short term. And then we can change the readout from maximum to current or loudness range whenever we have it set to short term. And when we have it set to momentary, you have maximum and LUFS integrated. All right, so that's the new readout on the master mixer. Now let's cut back to the original video. Yeah, like I said, I've been using this so much actually that I added all the tools to my radio menu. That way they're quickly accessible whenever I need them. And if you are curious or want to know more about how to set up that radio menu, I'll put a link in the description. I might do a video myself, but I think John does a much better job than I could do. So I'll put a link to the Reaper Blogs video on how to set up that radio menu. Very useful, especially with all these new loudness tools. Rather than trying to set up like a different keyboard shortcut, you can just have them all right here within just a couple clicks. So if you found all these tools helpful, please leave me a comment down below and tell me how you've been using them. I know I've been using them like crazy, so useful. And as always, I highly encourage you to join the Facebook group. A lot going on over there, a lot of smart people, a lot of knowledge sharing. So if you do need help, join the group, ask a question, a lot of people there to help you. Or if you're an expert, please join, because you can't have too many experts in that group. But that's all I got for you today. So I will see you in the next video.